my dear students, I hope you all are fine and doing well in your studies. So let's start, continue the topic of linear equations with some more questions. Okay, so we'll be continuing with the solve and verify with some more questions. Okay, so now the first question for today, as you can see on the board. So here you see here, till now we were solving equation which had only variable in one place, but now you are having variable in two places. So how to solve this type of equation? Okay, so first what you're going to do here, simply write down 2x plus 7. This side I have to open the bracket. Remember algebra, there is no sign between this one. This is multiplied to, 3 is multiplied to the entire x minus 1, whole of x minus 1. So first what you will do, first multiply 3 with x, then multiply 3 with 1. Okay, so 3 multiplied to x will give me how much? 3x, right? And already there is a minus, so now 3 multiplied to minus 1 will give me minus 3. 3 ones are 3 and minus, and 3 is carrying no sign, so plus multiplied to minus will give me how much? Minus. Okay, now what you are going to do, put the variables on the same side and the constants on the same side. So 2x is here, now I have to bring one more x from this side. What should I do? I will shift this 3x to the left hand side. So I get here minus 3x, because this was plus 3x, so when it comes to the left hand side becomes minus 3x. And here what is left out? Minus 3 is left out, 3x is gone this side. Now plus 7 I will be shifting that side, becomes what? Minus 7. Okay, very carefully do this shifting work. Okay, now you see you have here 2x minus 3x. Okay, so now both are like terms. Both are like terms, we can add and subtract. So 2 minus 3 will give me how much? Minus 1. And what is the literal coefficient? Coefficient is x only. Okay, so what shall I write here? Instead of writing minus 1, I will write here minus x. Minus x itself means that the numerical coefficient is minus 1. Right or not? So minus 1, and this side you have got minus 3 minus 7. Both are negative. Add them and give minus sign here. So that gives us x equals to 10, because this minus minus cancels out. Right? So we have got the value of x. Now let's verify. LHS is 2x plus 7. So 2x, now 2 is multiplied to x, x is 10 plus 7, that will give us 20 plus 7, 27. Clear? That's on the right hand side. 3 multiplied to x minus 1, so that means 3 multiplied, what is x? X is 10, 10 minus 1. So 3 multiplied to, because there are no signs that is multiplied, 10 minus 1 is how much? 9. So how much we got here? 27. So therefore LHS is equal to RHS is equal to 27, and then you have to write down, hence verified. Okay, let's come to this question. Same here also, the same manner we are going to solve. 4x is here, so I will bring 7x to the left hand side, it becomes minus 7x. Already I have minus 20 on the right hand side. Now minus 11 goes to the right hand side, becomes what? Plus 11. Okay, now both are like terms, have the literal coefficient same. So 4 minus 7 will give us minus 3. Minus 3, and write the literal coefficient x. Now 1 is minus, other one is plus. Subtraction you will do. 20 minus 11 is how much? 9. And written number is minus 20. Okay, so minus minus cancels out. X will be equal to 9. So 3 is multiplied here. When it goes to the right hand side, it will be divided by 9. So 3 threes are 9. Clear? Let's verify. LHS is 4x minus 11. So 4x, what is x? 3. That is 4 is multiplied to 3 minus 11. So we got here 12 minus 11, that is equal to 1. Okay? And what about RHS? RHS is 7x minus 20. That means 7 is multiplied to x. What is x? 3 minus 20. So 21 minus 20 will be equal to how much? 1. Yes? So that proves that the left hand side is equal to the right hand side. Hence, verified. Now students, let us come to the next question. Okay? So here, on the left hand side, you have 5 multiplied to 2x minus 1. Same procedure you are going to follow. First multiply 5 multiplied to 2x, then multiply 5 multiplied to minus 1. So 5 multiplied to 2x. 5 multiplied to 2x. 5 2's are 10. And what is the little coefficient? X only. So it will be how much? 10x. 5 multiplied to minus 1. 5 1's are 5. And plus into minus? Minus. Same way, 7 is first multiplied to 9, so 63. Minus into plus, minus 7 multiplied to x, 7x. Okay? So, in this way, we are going to solve it. Clear? Now, let's solve it further. So, next what I am going to do here, I will bring this minus 7x to the left hand side. So, it becomes what? Plus 7x. And already 63 is there. So, minus 5 we take into the right hand side becomes what? Plus 5. Clear? So, now both are like terms. 10 plus 7, 17x is equal to 68. So, x will be equal to 68 divided by 17. Right? Clear? So, 17, 4s are 68. So, we have got the answer 4. The value for x is 4. Let's verify. LHS 5 multiplied to 2x minus 1. Just put the value of x. 2 multiplied to x is 4 minus 1. Inside the bracket, first multiply 8 minus 1. So, 5 multiplied to 8 minus 1 is how much? 7. That will give us how much? 35. Let's check out right hand side also. Right hand side is 7 multiplied to 9 minus x. That means 7 multiplied to 9 minus what is x? 4. Yes? So, 7 multiplied 9 minus 4 will give us how much? 5. So, how much we obtained here? 35. That means the LHS is equal to the RHS, that is equal to 35. Let's verify. Okay? Now, let's come to the next question. Here also, you're going to do the same thing. Multiply 2 multiplied to y, 2y. 2 multiplied to plus 3, plus 6. Okay? Bracket is open now. Minus 8 is equal to 4y plus 2. Okay? So, now 2y, now plus 6 minus 8 will give us how much? Minus 2. Yes or no? One is positive, other one is negative. Subtraction 8 minus 6, 2 and the greater number is 8. Okay? So, that is equal to 4y plus 2. Now, let's shift the sides. 2y. So, this becomes minus 4y when you bring to the left hand side. And already there is 2 here. Plus 2 is there or not? And this 2 also goes that side, becomes plus 2. So, now we have got, now this is same, this is like term. You can see the little coefficient is yy. So, now 2 minus 4 is how much? Minus 2y is equal to 4. Okay? So, y will be equal to 4 divided by minus 2. Don't change minus 2 to plus 2 because here multiplication is getting converted to division. Okay? But minus 2 will remain minus 2. Multiplication is getting converted to division. Okay? So, now you have got integers. When you divide one positive and one negative number, answer will always be negative. Let's verify. Left hand side, y plus 3 minus 8. Yes. So now 2 multiplied to what is y? Y is minus 2 plus 3 minus 8. Right. So now in the bracket, what are you having? Minus 2 plus 3. One is negative, one other one is positive. Subtraction, 3 minus 2 is 1 and greater number is plus. So, plus 1, that means 2 is multiplied to, what is the answer inside the bracket? 1 minus 8. First multiply, 2 minus 8, how much you obtain? Minus 6. Now, the right hand side, 4y plus 2, okay? So, we have here 4 multiplied to, y is minus 2 plus 2, okay? You can put inside the bracket or if you want, you can write it directly, no problem. Now, 4 multiplied to minus 2 will be minus 8 plus 2. That will again give us minus 6. Okay. So, students, just keep practicing these numbers. See every step properly. Okay. So, you get a better understanding. Okay. Now, students, let us come to the last two questions for today. Okay. So, as you can see here, now let's shift the variable together. So, 3x is here. Here you have half x. So, bring half x this side. It becomes minus half x. Okay. And then you have 35 on the right hand side. Plus 35 is 35 only. Minus 40 goes that side, becomes what? Plus 40. Okay. Now, let's start solving it. So, now these two are what? Like terms. X and X. So, you have to just separate. You have to separately solve the number part. So, now students, just remember fractions. 3 minus 1 by 2. So, how are we going to solve this? You know that there is no denominator. What is the denominator? It's 1. So, what is the LCM of 1 and 2? It's 2 or not. Right? So, 1 multiplied to what is 2? 1 multiplied to 2 is 2. So, what you used to do? 2 multiplied to the numerator 3 minus now 2 multiplied to what is 2? It's 1. 1 multiplied to the numerator 1. Fractions, I hope you all know. So, 6 minus 1 by 2, we'll get in here how much? 5 by 2. Yes or no? So this way first solve the number part, right? So we have got here the number part, the numerical coefficient as 5 by 2. So simply write down 5 by 2 and the literal coefficient is x. Okay? Now that is equal to 35 plus 40 will give us 75. Okay? Now let's solve it. Okay? Now x will be equal to what? Now x will be equal to 1. You see here 5 by 2 is multiplied to x. 5 by 2 is multiplied to x. So when it goes this side, it will be divided by x. Yes, it will be divided by x. Yes or no? As a whole, 5 by 2 is what? A fraction. It's a fraction having a numerator and a denominator. So now 75 is on the right hand side. It's a whole number. So this is like a complex fraction. Complex fraction means what? Where one of the, either the numerator is a fraction or the denominator is a fraction, or both numerator and denominator can also be a fraction. Yes or no? So now, how do you solve this type of numbers? It is same as, if you face difficulty, you can write like this. See, it is same as what? 75 divided by 5 by 2. Same thing or not? Yes? So that implies x will be equal to, now you know how to divide fractions. How, what are you going to do here? Change the division to multiplication and write the reciprocal of the divisor. Write the reciprocal of the divisor. What is the divisor? 5 by 2. So it becomes what? 2 by 5 divisor. You can write the reciprocal, or you also call it as multiplicative inverse. Remember it. Okay. So we have got here. Cancel it. 5, 15s are. Yes or no? So now 15 multiplied to 2 is only remaining. So how much you got here? 30. So very carefully you can solve it. Okay. And if you want, you can skip this step. And you can write directly. Okay. This is just to show you I have written. If you are comfortable, you can skip this step and you can write directly. Clear? Now next students, let's verify it. LHS is 3x minus 40. So what is x I have got here? 30. So that means 3 is multiplied to 30 minus 40. So that is 90 minus 40 will give me a 50. Let's check the right hand side now. Right hand side, half of x plus 35, right? So half multiplied to x. What is x? 30. Plus 35. So first go for multiplication. 2 15s are 30. So 15 plus 35 will give us again 50 only. So this proves that the left hand side is equal to the right hand side. Okay. Let's go to the next question. So once again you have to multiply the same value. First multiply 5 to x. So 5x. 5 with minus 4. Minus 20. Then minus 1 is there. Don't forget to write. So you have your minus 7x plus 3, right? So 5x is here. I'll bring the, okay, let me first solve this. Minus 20 minus 1 will give us how much? Minus 21, both are negative. Then minus 7x plus 3, right? So now let me shift. 5x minus 7x comes this side, becomes what? Plus 7x, and 3 is already there. Yes or no? Plus 3. Minus 21 goes that side, becomes what? Plus 21. Okay. So now both are like terms. 5 plus 7 is how much? 12. And this is x. 3 plus 21 is 24. So that implies x is equal to 24 divided by 12. Cancel it. So how much you obtained here? 2. Right? So let's verify it. Left hand side is 5 multiplied to x minus 4 multiplied to minus 1. So that gives us 5. X is what? 2. So 2 minus 4 multiplied to, 2 minus 4 minus 1. Now this is 5 is multiplied 2 minus 4. So what is the value of 2 minus 4? First solve the bracket. So 5 will be multiplied to minus 2. This is minus 2 obviously. 2 minus 4 is minus 2. Then you have minus 1 here. So first you should go for multiplication. What are the two things multiplied? 5 is first multiplied to minus 2 only. Yes or no? So 5 2s are 10. Plus into minus? Minus. So this part you have solved, minus 10. Now what is the remaining part? Minus 1. Now what you got here? Minus 10, minus 1, both are negative. Add and give minus sign. That means minus 11. Okay. Let's check on the right hand side also. Minus 7x plus 3. Okay. So minus 7 multiplied to 2 plus 3. Right. So multiply these two. First multiplication. Minus 14. Yes. Minus 14 plus 3. One is negative, other one is positive. Subtraction. 14 minus 3 is 11 and greater number is 14. So how much you got here? Minus 11. So this proves that the left hand side is equal to the right hand side. Hence verified. So I hope students Your idea will be getting clear. Please watch the video carefully, see each and every step. Don't get confused. Try to understand the numbers. And the next class, we'll be discussing the word problem. Till then, take care.